Hi, this is Annie Gibson. Welcome to Healthy Living with Annie Food Institute, learning basic skills for healthy eating. Today I'm just going to make a simple barbecue sauce, and this barbecue sauce was actually adapted from divascancook.com. It's not my original recipe, and the recipe just calls for one small chicken cut up with the skin removed, and you can season it to taste with garlic powder, onion powder, sea salt, and black pepper. This is the sauce that I've just put together. The sauce is so delicious. Ever since I discovered this recipe, I have not bought barbecue sauce, and because this is just so delicious, and I absolutely love to make it for my family and even for myself. So this barbecue sauce is really a winner. But what you see here in the cup is just simply a half cup of organic ketchup, 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, 3 tablespoons of brown sugar, or you could substitute about 2.5 tablespoons of honey. I would recommend organic raw honey, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 1/4 cup of apple cider vinegar, 2 teaspoons of chili powder, 2 teaspoons of paprika, 1 teaspoon of red pepper flakes, 2 teaspoons of prepared mustard, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. And that's all that it is. Put it all in here. It just takes a few minutes just to blend everything. And then I'm going to go ahead and season my chicken. What I have is chicken breast. I'm just going to rinse it and cut it up and get it started. I've gone ahead and seasoned my chicken with sea salt, black pepper, onion, and garlic powder. Really just season it to my taste. I've gone ahead and mixed my chicken up. I'm just going to go ahead right now and just take it and put it. Just going to put it in a pan just so. And one of the things that you can do, actually, if you wanted to and you have the time, you could actually double the sauce and you could just make chicken nuggets. This will just be something really fun for the children to eat, especially if you have younger children. They would love to have this as chicken nuggets. And actually, you can make it like this, the chicken breast, and then just take it once you're done and cut it up into little chunks just like chicken nuggets. And they would love that. I'm just going to go ahead and finish putting this in the dish. I'm just going to go ahead and cover both sides of the chicken with the sauce. And if you've noticed, I put the sauce that I'm going to be dipping into in a different container, because I'm going to hold this back, actually, because it's really a good dipping sauce. If you want a little bit more barbecue sauce on the chicken, I would recommend just holding some back so you dip it into it with a raw spoon, and you can just set that aside. So you just go ahead and you just brush barbecue sauce liberally, just have fun with it on both sides of the chicken. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over and baste the other side as well. Okay, now, so both sides of the barbecue chicken is basted, and it's a wonderful sauce, and my oven is already on 400 degrees. It's preheated already, and so I'm going to bake for at least 4 to 5 minutes to 1 hour or until it's done. But in between, I'm going to check it and baste it with the barbecue sauce as needed throughout the cooking process. And what I usually do is I let it cook for about 40 minutes on one side, and then before I turn it over, and then baste it on the other side. So when it's ready, we're just going to remove it from the oven, let it rest for about 5 to 7 minutes before serving. So we're going ahead now and get this in the oven. And it's going to cook uncovered. It's been about 20 minutes. So I'm just checking on the chicken. I'm just going to let it bake for another 30 minutes before I baste it and turn it over. Okay, now this is one of the things about the recipe that I don't like. When the broth cooks out of the chicken, it just kind of makes it watery, and it just kind of decreases the concentration of the flavor. And so what I'm going to do is just pour this broth off as much as I can, because I really wanted to just get down to the really good flavor of the barbecue sauce. So I'm going to go ahead and baste this chicken a little bit more while it's cooking on this side. I'm just going to let it cook just a little bit longer. Don't have to baste it too much, because it's really, the barbecue sauce is really sticking to it. So I'm just going to go ahead and just in a few minutes just flip it over. And these are chicken breasts, so chicken breast is not going to take as long to cook as chicken that has the bone in it. And so that was another reason why I poured off the broth, because if chicken with the bone in it, the broth would just eventually just reduce. But I just kind of went ahead and poured some of that off, not all of it, but some. Okay, this chicken is really looking delicious. I'm just going to go ahead and turn this over. I poured out most of that broth, but this chicken breast is basically done. I just want the barbecue sauce now to just kind of cook a little bit more into it. And I'm also going to baste it again. But I poured the most of the broth off, especially because of the breast. Like I said, it cooks quicker with the water in there, and so that's another reason why I just went ahead and poured that off. So I'm just going to go ahead and finish turning these over, and then I'm going to baste it on this side and put it back in the oven. It's been cooking now for a good 35 minutes, so we're going to go ahead and put this back in the oven just for another 10 minutes or so. For the barbecue sauce, this is going to brown up a bit, and the barbecue sauce can really get baked into it. I'm going to do my other dish that I have in the oven as well the same way. Okay, this chicken has cooked up quite nicely. I'm going to go ahead and plate it up. This remember as well that I mentioned earlier is that you can really take this and just kind of cut it up and make some nuggets out of it for the children, the younger children, and it will be a fun way for them to eat. So please go ahead and do that. And again, this is just a barbecue chicken, and I do, you know, I don't do it all the time, but I, you know, just, I do enjoy it. And like I said, since I started this barbecue, making this barbecue sauce, I don't really buy barbecue sauce anymore because this is really good. And again, this, I adapted this recipe from Divas Can Cook, and it's just really wonderful way to go. And I did tweak it some because the original recipe called for about 6 tablespoons of brown sugar, and I put in 3, just because even if you're health conscious, you really don't want all that sweetness. So just try to make things as healthy as it can be with the integrity of the recipe holding up. And then the original recipe also asked for 4 tablespoons of butter, and I just put in maybe a couple tablespoons of olive oil. And again, the integrity of the recipe held up with that as well. And I also, the recipe called for 2 to 3 teaspoons of salt. And what I did, because I seasoned my chicken to taste with the onion powder, the garlic powder, and the black pepper and the salt, you really only need like a dash of salt in the sauce, and you don't really need that much salt in the sauce if you're going to season your chicken. And I found that it just works better in terms of flavor if I go ahead and season my chicken. So again, if you want to develop a really good flavor during the cooking process, just baste the chicken with the drippings from the pan and just kind of go in, and you can take the brush and just kind of brush it over. I just really want to just kind of give you that tip as well. And again, who said that healthy food had to be boring and tasteless? So, you know, I'm an advocate for clean eating, and this does have a little bit of sugar in. I think just about all the ingredients are good, but it did have some sugar in it. But it's just the sugar that's in the entire recipe, so you have to take that in consideration. And I make this dish as I do with my oven fried chicken. It's just kind of, I guess you can say, my little cheat that I do. And so when I make it, I make sure with this and also with the oven fried chicken, I'm making when people are coming over, and then I can share it, and then that way I'm not eating all of it myself. So those are just some tips that I found that kind of helped me stay on the straight and narrow in terms of my healthy lifestyle plan. And this is some of the barbecue sauce that I held back. This is a clean sauce, and so if I need be, I can just kind of dip it in it or spoon it over it a little bit on my plate. And this is just a really tasty recipe. Okay, so I'm ready to sit down for dinner. I have on my plate some jollof rice, a Nigerian rice called jollof rice that my daughter made for me. It's charred, and then my barbecue chicken. So I got my lean protein, I have my good carb, and that is brown rice. Then a Swiss chard that I just sauteed with garlic and onions and a little bit of olive oil, and so I'm really good to go. This is Healthy Living with Annie Food Institute, learning basic skills for healthy eating. I just encourage you to go to healthylivingwithannie.com. There's all kinds of resources on that website that will help you to gain strength if you're dealing with destructive eating habits, out of control eating habits. You just can't seem to get it together. Every year you're starting over with your healthy lifestyle plan. I really encourage you to go on the website, look at all the resources they're designed for you. I will encourage you to tune in. I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Put on the New Nature. It's you can Google either Put on the New Nature or Annie Maiden Gibson, and Put on the New Nature will come up. And I just subscribe, and so whenever I do a Bible teaching, that will come to you. And that is designed as well to help you to walk in who you really are in Christ, strengthen your inner man, and just walk in those things that God is calling us to do in this hour. Again, this is Annie Gibson with Healthy Living with Annie Food Institute, learning basic skills for healthy eating, and have a heart healthy day.